Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of Growing Wild Farm and Garden, where normally I want to encourage you to grow wild and plant something, but today I want you to grow wild and get some bees. Anyway, today is definitely a beekeeping video. We're at October 10th, I believe today is, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to check to see how the queen is laying, because I haven't actually checked her brood pattern in a while, and I'm going to see if these honey supers over here need extra room or how they're doing since the fall flow started. I'm going to check Bro Hive for the same thing just to be sure they have enough room, make sure everything's going good. So, let's get going. Girls have been a little upset recently because of that armadillo that's still around, and the fence is actually right here beside me, so they might still be kind of upset, but I'm hoping after this many weeks they're not. One girl that's a little nervous about me. That's definitely a roar. So, I expected there to be more nectar, or at least honey, in here. So the flow is just not as strong as I anticipated it being, which means this top box is probably going to be mostly empty. We'll check out a middle frame though. This next frame is completely empty. Wax foundation, and they haven't even built on it. I wonder if I came right around baby bee flights. They're coming up in the air more than they normally do. And on this side, there's one little, do you see that red? I hope you can. That little red dot. They've been getting into some hummingbird feeders. This right here is more full. Right there in that middle, you can probably see it. But this is frame 5. So this top box is basically empty. They're just starting to fill it, it looks like. But I'm going to move a couple more frames and just check. She bumped my hand. So, I'm going to give them a little bit more smoke. Yeah, these other frames are also just about as empty, so this top box is still pretty friggin' empty. I'd say probably 85-90% empty. They've filled a little bit on a couple frames, but not a whole lot. I'm just gonna leave it there and see if they can do any better. Moving on. We also want to see if there's any mite problems. Or small hive beetles, really small hive beetles are more something I can see. So something I may not have told you guys before, but I am trying to raise a strong stock for our area. I want them to be resistant to beetles. I want them to be hygienic so that they get the beetles and corral them. I want them to take the mites out. I want them to do this all on their own without too much treatment for me, because I want them to be able to survive on their own without my help. So that's my goal. That's why you're not going to hear me too much talking about mite tests or things like that. I do them, and I will do them, especially right as it starts to get cold, probably again in November, when it's starting to cool off. But you're not going to see me or hear me talk too much about, you know, these things. I try to give them a little help with like the Swiffer sweeper pads and some wintergreen grease, which I can talk more about that after we're finished. But that's about all the help they get from me. The struggle is real, keeping smokers keep going. Other side and check one of those frames that I know used to be empty, was empty. Oh man. Alright, so this is frame 9. And it's empty. It's so much more empty than I was expecting. There's a little bit of capping right there, and there's a beetle that I gotta kill. Another one. This is no good. I may have to take off that top box. Alright. So the whole reason that I gave them that top box before is because we were coming into the goldenrod and the autumn clematis, which is a big indicator of a fall flow here, but this box is empty. This box looks empty. And I see a bunch of beetles. So to keep the beetles from being able to take over too much, I'm going to go ahead and probably take whatever frames they already have nectar or honey in on this top box, put it in this bottom box, and just take a box off. We don't want to give them too much room. Then they have to guard everything. So let's try to make it easier on them by giving them less room to manage, and then they can fill up one box at a time. This is what we want to see. That's capped honey. Almost a full frame, both sides. That's what I was hoping to see down in this bottom box for sure, a lot of it. Another frame full. These are much heavier. Almost full. She got right up on my face. I didn't want to breathe. This one's almost full. This is frame one. Frame four. Almost full. Frame five is about half full on this side. Frame five. So it looks like they worked on those first couple and then they started working their way over towards frame 10. The other side's empty. So they're working on them. This frame's empty. Another beetle. Jeez. The girls are trying to keep the beetles away. I'm gonna switch that frame out. Yep, taking this one too. Actually, I'm already starting to see robbing, so I have to close them up. I'm just gonna leave them with both boxes. I don't have any other choice right now. So I'm closing the top entrance, and I'm really concerned that what I was just seeing is some robbing that was going on in the boxes that I had open. I don't think these bees flying may be mine. And I'm gonna stuff that entrance with some grass and what's and stuff. Now what that'll do is that'll give my girls a chance to defend that entrance a little bit better, because I know that they're on guard, and if we were having a robbing situation and I'm seeing what I think I'm seeing, then they'll work it out from here. There's a lot of bees in the air right now. And I'm pretty sure some of them came from this box I had over here. What I was seeing is in one of those frames, there were bees clustered around a part of the frame that they had sealed, and they were unsealing the capped honey, which means I don't think those were my bees. And you can see this one isn't happy. So I'm gonna wait and see what happens, but I'm not getting into them anymore. I can't. They're in much more of a dearth than I thought they were, especially considering the time frame of the year. And I got a bunch of guard bees all over me, so I'm gonna walk off. Okay. It's the next morning after the inspection I was attempting to do. And I'm sorry if the wind is windy. But just to double check if I was correct about the robbing, I wanted to come out here and see if I saw any dead bees, because that's a number one sign of robbing, is they fight and they kill each other. And if you can see, there's one dead bee there, and there's another one down here under the grass. And so I'm confident to say that they probably were getting robbed. It could have even been Bravo Hive that was doing it, unfortunately. But that means that we are definitely in a dearth, or at least we're not in a strong flow, and that sucks. But it happens. So what I saw, and I didn't get it on camera because they started chasing me off, is there was one frame that I tried to explain about when I was in there. There was one frame where they were clustered up around a capped honey on just one frame, and there were a group of them, and you can tell that they were uncapping it to eat it. They were uncapping it because that's what they were doing. They were robbing it. After we left, you saw I put the grass in the entrance to reduce the amount of space that any robber bees had to get into my hive and give the other girls a chance to fend off any intruders. So there are some dead bees. There are not nearly as many bees out now that you can see. And I think that I did the right thing by just closing it up really fast before it got really bad, because it could have gotten a lot worse. But we'll talk more about that in a second if I can show you some good pictures or videos. Okay, so let's talk about robbing. Robbing is when another hive, whether it's wild or in your own apiary, comes to another hive and starts to rob all the resources, all the honey that it can get. During a dearth, which is what happens when there's not a lot of blooming flowers with nectar, robbing is a more common occurrence. So what we saw was, I'm assuming, robbing after I opened up the hive. So Alpha Hive was open. And that led to the smell of honey and nectar coming out into the air. So either Bravo Hive is the one that robbed, or another hive from somewhere else started sending scouts or had scouts in the area, smelled it, started taking honey. The way that we know this is when I was looking at one of those frames, there was a clump about this big of bees on a frame that had capped honey on it. And the capped honey was being opened up. It was being decapped by the bees. Now, you've probably seen some of my other beekeeping videos, and if you haven't, please go take a look. There are videos where you can see that the bees haven't finished capping a cell, and the cell is just a little circle. Maybe there's just a tiny circle in the middle of the cell or something like that. It looks perfect, like a circle. When they decap it, it looks edgy. It looks like literally somebody has taken their teeth to it, because that's exactly what they're doing. They're taking their little jaws to it to open up the wax, and then they're getting the nectar or honey out of the cell. And that's what robber bees do. So when I noticed that, I had already noticed there were a lot of bees in the air, and that was a little abnormal for my inspections. But when I saw that, I got a little suspicious. I went ahead and closed everything down. You saw that. And I went ahead and left all the boxes on because I didn't want the robbing to continue. I put the grass in front of the entrance because I do not have an entrance reducer, which is literally what it sounds like. It's a piece of wood that's the length of a hive opening that restricts. So you turn it one way and the opening's about this big. You turn it another way, the opening's about this big. You take it completely out and it's as wide as the hive. And I don't have an introducer on Alpha Hive. I have an introducer on Bravo Hive, and it's only been at the smallest opening. It's an old entrance reducer, and they've actually chewed it down a little bit on another side, so there's two entrances in that entrance reducer, but it still helps prevent robbing. On an Alpha Hive, I shoved the grass into that hive opening specifically to try and help Alpha Hive prevent any robbers from coming in any further. You watched the video a little bit, you saw how much activity was around that front, and it could be that some of the other foragers were just coming home, and you saw quite a bit of foragers just coming home, and that's quite a bit of, you know, bees, especially with a hive the size of Alpha. However, that could have also been robbers. I waited a little bit and I looked out my window. There's literally a window that looks directly at the hives in my bedroom. And I looked outside because they were chasing me. I felt safer through the window. And I saw a couple of bees sort of buzzing around the crevices that I have in the boxes. So between each box, there's like a tiny little slit sometimes that the bees normally will propolis over if there's an opening. They were looking at those little slits, and that obviously meant that either it was a bee looking for a new place to go in, or it was a robber trying to find any possible way that they can in. And that's what I think really was happening. Bravo Hive is so close by, and there's still a new hive, that it could have been them, but it also could have been other hives from nearby. I honestly don't know if there are any established apiaries anywhere close to us. I believe there is off that direction. I saw it one time, I believe this summer, but I haven't been able to see it since over on another farm, I think. I don't want to say that and be wrong, but I think there's another apiary off that direction. Either case, I wanted to protect my bees. I didn't want them to lose all the resources that they had already gathered. And so I shut it up as fast as I possibly could. So other than that, I don't know what else to say about robbing, but that's what I'm assuming happened.